happy morning to all my dear children. Welcome back to your computer class. Dear children, we were studying your chapter number 1, that is evolution of computers. Today we are going to move to part 2 of this chapter. Let's see what we are having today in our part 2. Now here we are having generations of computer. Today we are going to learn about generations of computer. जैसे कि हमारे grandfather हैं, then father, generations हैं, वैसे ही in the same way there are generations of the computer as well. Let's see.
So computers were not invented in a single day. They have evolved through several years and many generations. Based on technological advancement, development of computer technology from ENIAC, ENIAC, to its present form can be categorized into different generations.
Now, first of all, computers are not invented in a single day. Obviously, जो generations है computer की उसमें बहुत साल गए होंगे, many years. So, dear children, they have evolved through several years and many generations. बहुत सारी generations भी थी. Based on the technological advancement, development of computer technology from ENIAC, that is ENIAC. ENIAC, that was the generation, to its present form. Means present form में आज जो हम use कर रहे हैं, the laptops which we are using, can be categorized into different generations. We will see these generations in this chapter.
First generation computers, 1940 to 1956. Some of the characteristics of the first generation computers were, they used vacuum tubes as a main component. Vacuum tubes were made of glass and gave off a lot of heat, just like light bulbs.
Now, first of all, the first generation computer, the period was from 1940 to 56. Some of the characteristics were like, now first generation computer used the vacuum tubes. You can see in this picture, they are like light bulbs, okay, जो हमारे normally घरों में होते हैं, light bulbs होते हैं. Now, as the main component, vacuum tubes were the main component in first generation computer. Dear children, you have to remember this. You can also underline in your textbook. Vacuum tubes were made of glass and gave a lot of heat, just like light bulbs. जैसे कि हमारे light bulbs हमारे घर में होते हैं, they are of glass. And जब वो बहुत गर्म भी होते हैं, जब उनको जला के फिर switch off करते हैं, yes. So in the same way, these were also made of glass and they gave a lot of heat just as light bulbs.
They were very expensive, large in size and had small internal storage. Input was based on punched cards and paper tape.
Now dear children, the light bulbs are very small, जो हमारे घरों में होते हैं. But these vacuum tubes were large in size and were very expensive. Understood and had a small internal storage. Means जो उसमें storage होती थी बहुत ही छोटी होती थी. Input was based on punch cards and paper tape. जो उसमें input डालता था उसमें punch cards और paper tape पे based थे. Understood? Next.
Some examples of the first generation computers are as follows. Mark 1 was designed by Howard H. Aiken in the year 1944. It was about 15 meters long and the wires connecting the various parts of 100 kilometers long. The machine was slow and took 3-5 seconds per calculation, but it was the first fully automatic calculator ever.
Now, we will study some examples of the first generation computer. The first one was Mark 1. You have to remember the name. It was designed by Howard H. Aiken. It was designed by Howard H. Aiken in the year 1944. Dear children, please remember this. It was about 15 meters long and the wires connecting the various parts of the machine were about 800 kilometers long. So you can see this in the picture. It is so long. Yes, the machine was slow. Now this machine was slow and took 3 to 5 seconds per calculation. As this machine was slow, तो वो 3 to 5 seconds लेती थी calculation करने में. It was the first fully automatic calculator ever. You have to remember this. The first fully automatic calculator was Mark 1. Understood?
India, electronic, numerical, integrator and computer. The ENIAC, ENIAC, was developed by John Presper Eckert and John W. Mosley in the year 1946. It was fully electronic digital computer.
Now, dear children, the second example is ENIAC. What is the full form? Electronic, numerical, integrator and computer. You have to remember the full form. Electronic, numerical, integrator and computer. It was developed by John Presper Eckert and John W. Mosley in the year 1946. Remember the names, dear children. It was a fully electronic digital computer. ENIAC was fully electronic digital computer.
It consisted of 18,000 battery tubes, occupying an area of 63 square meters and weighed more than 27,000 kilograms, whereas Mark 1 took about 5 seconds for adding two large numbers. The ENIAC, ENIAC, could do it in 200 microseconds. It was originally built to help the army in launching bombs and missiles more accurately. It did not have stored programs. It had to be programmed by manually wiring the code for each task.
Now, ENIAC consisted of 18,000 vacuum tubes, which we have studied. The main component of the first generation computer. Yes, it consists of 18,000 vacuum tubes, occupied an area of 63 square meter. You can see, it's like a room. Okay, wo itna bada tha. And weighed more than 27,000 kilograms. Whereas Mark 1, now here's a small comparison between Mark 1 and ENIAC. Mark 1 took 5 seconds for adding two numbers. But ENIAC could do it in 200 microseconds. Means, wo usse fast tha. Okay, so here is the development. The first one was Mark 1, then was ENIAC. It is a development of the computers. Understood? It was originally built to help the army in launching bulbs and bombs and missiles more accurately. Kiske liye wo use hota tha? In the army. For launching the bombs and the missiles. It could not have stored program. It can be stored, like it has to be programmed manually, writing the code. Nowadays, as we are using the Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, ये सारे क्या हैं? Stored programs होते हैं हमारे computers में. जबकि ENIAC जो पहले के generation से computer थे, it didn't have any stored programs. We have to program them manually by each and every code. Understood? Next.
UNIVAC 1, Universal Automatic Computer. UNIVAC 1 was developed in the year 1951, again by John Presper Eckert and John W. Mosley. It was the first commercially available electronic computer and also the first computer to handle both numeric and text data.
Now, this, okay, the third one, the third example. The first one was, tell me. Yes, and the second one was ENIAC and then UNIVAC. The three examples which we're studying, Mark 1, ENIAC and UNIVAC, the three examples. Now, in the third example also, you have to remember the short form, that is Universal Automatic Computer, the full form of the UNIVAC 1. What is the full form here? Universal Automatic Computer. It was developed in 1951. Again, who developed? The John Presper Eckert and John W. Mosley, who invented the ENIAC. Same person have developed the UNIVAC as well. It was the first commercially available electronic computer. ये जो कंप्यूटर था वो कमर्शियली अवेलेबल था, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंप्यूटर, दैट इज की लाइक वी कैन यूज इट कंप्यूटर फॉर द कमर्शियल पर्पसेस यूजेस. एंड ऑल्सो द फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर टू हैंडल बोथ द न्यूमरिक एंड द टेक्स्ट डेटा. हियर यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर. यस, नाउ दिस कंप्यूटर इट वॉज द फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर टू हैंडल बोथ द न्यूमरिक एंड द टेक्स्ट डेटा. दैट मीन्स द नंबर्स एंड द लेटर्स. Understood, dear children, till here?
Limitations of first generation computers were as follows. Their operating speed was quite slow. Their power consumption was very high. They required large space for installation. Their potential to be programmed for tasks was quite limited.
Now, there are some limitations also of the first generation computer. जब किसी चीज़ के limitations होते हैं, किसी के drawbacks होते हैं, then only there is a development. Understood? So, there were some limitations of the first generation computer, then again there was a development. But we will see first of all the limitations. What were the? The operating speed was quite slow. As we have studied, उनकी जो speed थी वो बहुत slow थी. They required large space for installation. We have studied in UNIVAC how much space they required. Yes, so it is a limitation. Their potential to be programmed for task was quite limited. Means, वो एक ही साथ सारे programs के लिए नहीं run कर पाता था. The task was very limited. The potential was very limited, dear children.
They could solve only one problem at a time. They were hugely expensive to build.
Now, they could solve only one problem at a time and they were very expensive as well because they were very large in size. Okay, toh wo expensive toh honge. So that was a limitation. Dear children, I hope you are clear with the first generation computer. See, now this is a second generation computer which we will study in the next part. But for today, this is a small worksheet which you have to do. Dear children, this action time is there in your textbook and you have to solve it in textbook. What you have to do? Identify and write the name of the pictures given below. Now these pictures, they were from the history of the computers which we studied in part 1. So you have to just quickly recall them and you have to write their names over here. That's it. The first one is like Abacus. So here you will write Abacus. In the same way you will identify these three and you will write their names. Dear children, please go through the chapter till now. Okay, we will meet next time with something more interesting in computer. Till then, bye-bye. God bless you all.